Hi, I'm Jason Tam. I play Paul in A Chorus Line. I'm originally from Honolulu, Hawaii. That's where I was born and raised. I lived there for, you know, my whole life. Beautiful, awesome place to grow up. I have two older sisters, and so, you know, like any younger sibling, I kind of looked up to them in admiration, and I kind of followed them in whatever they did. I would do what they did. So at first it was soccer, and I did soccer, and then they did piano, and I wanted to play the piano and gymnastics. And ultimately, my oldest sister, Emily, got into community theater. She started doing a lot of that.
Second starting, right? Straight on till morning.
What a funny address.
No, it isn't.
How do you get there?
You just follow the golden arrows. It's a special place.
Is it?
Yes, it's a tiny island crowned with one adventure after another. If I tell you, will you believe me?
Oh, yes. Please tell me.
I know.
Eventually, I was doing Music Man, and I was playing Wontorek in Music Man, and Tommy Aguilar, who was one of the replacement Pauls in the New York version of A Chorus Line, and I think he originated it in London, he did, was coming and sort of scouting for kids because there was a Canadian tour of Les Mis that was coming through the islands. He came up to me after the show and was like, you know, commented, he said that he thought I had a lot of potential and that he really thought that I should audition for this and talk to my mom. My mom was a little hesitant, but she ultimately let me audition for it, and I got it. I did it in Hamilton for about 3 weeks and learned the role, and then came back and did it in Honolulu, and that was it. But I guess they keep the kids on file so that if, you know, they have an opening, they don't have to have these big expensive auditions. And so I think couple months later, maybe like even a month later, I got a call and they asked me if I wanted to come to New York. And I was just like, yeah, okay. When I was doing Les Mis, there were these, you know, there were two Gavroches and three girls that shared Cosette and Eponine, young Eponine. And at one point, it was just me and two other girls because one of the kids was on vacation and one of the other girls was gone, absent. And for some reason or another, I don't know, Equity has some rules where they didn't want me to go on for all eight performances as Gavroche, young Gavroche. So they had to put Lacey Chabert on as Gavroche twice and me as young Eponine twice. So I had like the full-on dress, I had a wig and a little bonnet and a little doll, and I didn't have to do anything. All I had to do was run on stage and, like, you know, stick my tongue out at young Cosette. And then, you know, I think Thénardier picked me up or something. After I was finished, you know, performing in New York, I went home and kind of, that was that. I still did a lot of community theater. After high school, I saw my sister. I went to go visit her. She went to the musical theater program at Carnegie Mellon. So I went to go see her and I was just like, oh my gosh, these kids are so good. And I felt like there was so much more that I had to learn. And that's what made me really want to pursue acting. I got accepted to a couple places, but I didn't have one place that I really, really wanted to go to. And eventually I chose NYU, mostly for the fact that it was in New York, more so than that it was NYU. The first time that I auditioned for anything was a summer. I was auditioning for Music Circus. I was surprised though, because I grew up on the Chorus Line movie, and you know, you watch that opening sequence and literally it's an entire stage filled with people and everyone is together, everyone is like just it, and they look great, and I was just like, wow, you know, Broadway people. But when I got to it and I was sort of like, okay, you know, I'm not too shabby, like I can do this. I actually ended up getting, you know, a couple shows there that summer. As I was doing that, I was, you know, kind of auditioning for some other things, and I got to do She Loves Me at the Guthrie Theater. I got to do that for a couple months, and I went back and did another summer at Music Circus. And then I did a TV show called Beyond the Break for 3 months. And then I came back to New York. And that's when they were in the final audition process for Chorus Line. I remember when I found out that I got the job, it wasn't like a burst of like crazy, like, oh my gosh. It was more of just like I felt like I had been holding my breath for the past week, and all of a sudden I could just like breathe again. He tends to be a little bit more on the shy side, and I can definitely connect with that. You know, like, I love to perform. I love it, you know, obviously. But I like to perform on stage, and I don't necessarily like to, you know, draw attention to myself otherwise in everyday life. Like, I'm definitely not the life of the party, and I'm okay with that, you know? He's got an energy when he performs, you know? But as soon as you ask him to, you know, start talking about his real life, it's like, hands in the pocket, shoulders up, tension, 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 you know? He just doesn't want to do it, and I think I'm can be the same way. I can be a little shy sometimes. In terms of favorite moments, I think past the end of my monologue, after it's done, and there's this moment between me and Zach. It's like a little secret, and it gives me a sense of catharsis, of release. You know, he's just looking for somebody to say, I understand, and, you know, acceptance, just, it's that simple, but that complicated. And I think that's what we're all looking for, you know? And that's why I think the show is so important and so effective to so many people, because that's what everybody's looking for, no matter who they are.